Hi friends, welcome to this video. In this video we are going to understand the issue faced in case both the PC will have the same MAC address. So we have configured two PC and connected it to a switch. Now I will just write down the MAC address as well as the IP address of the PC0 here, and in case of PC1, this is the IP address, and if we see, I will first change the MAC address to just changing the last character, and we'll make both the MAC address same by just changing the last character of the hex code. So let me explain you what happens when Ethernet frame moves. Now when we ping from, this is the source and this is the destination, when we do a ping, the Ethernet the IP packet, which is encapsulated in the Ethernet frame, so you can imagine that this is the header and this is the trailer, and there is the IP packet inside, it is sent over the layer 2. And as this PC does not have any entry in the MAC address, and neither the switch does have any entry in the MAC address, what will do, whenever the switch receives the frame, it will put as the one entry that on FA0, this is FA0, and suppose this is FA1, FA0 I have a MAC address of, let's say, the last 4 hex codes, this one, so it will put the entry of this MAC address into FA0. Now in case both are same, the switch puts this entry with this you can say details, where the port is FA0 and the MAC address is here, and when it forwards the packet, it tries to forward the packet, it looks into its MAC address table and it says that the originating port is the same as the, you can say, the destination port. It will discard the frame and it will generate an error. So let's see, let us create a packet here, and the destination would be, and the source would be 101, and let's see, our sequence number is 2. I've created a packet ICMP echo request, so let's play it. So the packet will go, and you can see, actually I have created one ICMP request earlier as well, so you are able to see two packets here. So in the PDO detail you can see that the destination MAC and the source MAC are different right now. So let me try to change the MAC address, and as soon as I change the MAC address, okay, I've reset the simulation, and if I do it, so now in this outbound PDO details you see that the destination MAC and the source MAC address are the same. Let me do one thing, clear MAC. Okay, so I've cleared the MAC address table. Now this packet is forwarded to the switch. The second packet is also forwarded to the switch, and you see nothing is going through the switch, and you can see here it has the MAC address same, so it's being discarded by the switch. Now if we check the details of the switch in the MAC address table, it will be here. If we do a ping, so now let's check. So you can see here the MAC address has been updated with the port FA01, but the communication is not going through, as you will be getting a request timeout. So let's do a update of the MAC address again and let's try to ping it. So now the communication is going, and if we check the MAC address, so until unless you have a unique MAC address in your network, which by case is always unique because the OEM, the original equipment manufacturer of your network interface card, gets the OUI. OUI is the organization unique identifier from IEEE, and this is a 3-digit hex which is received from IEEE. And this is used to generate unique MAC addresses. So this was a simple exercise in which we checked what would happen in case you have a duplicate MAC address, which by logic should not happen in a real-time network. But this was for your understanding only. In case you have any questions, just put them in the comment box and I would be happy to reply. Hope you enjoyed this video. Have a great day.